Hi, I'm Cliff Sadoff, Extension Specialist at Purdue University, and in this video, we're going to discuss lacebugs.
Lacebugs are small insects that discolor plant leaves when they feed on plant sap. Leaves of heavily infested plants appear to be bleached white. You can confirm your lacebug diagnosis by turning over leaves and looking for black fecal spots, eggs, as well as live lacebugs or the remains of old skins. Adult lacebugs are easily recognized by their pitted, clear wings held flat over their body. Adults lay elongate eggs on the undersides of leaves. Lacebugs hatch out of the tops of these eggs into spiny nymphs that feed on leaf tissue. Lacebug nymphs get increasingly spiny with each subsequent molt. Young lacebugs feed in groups and, like adults, excrete black tar-like spots of excrements that are clearly visible to the naked eye. Their group feeding is also a defensive behavior. Here you see a nymph jumping wildly to alert its siblings to danger. The orange-colored nymph has recently molted and has yet to turn brown. Lacebugs have multiple generations starting in late spring. Lacebugs that attack evergreen plants like azaleas and rhododendrons winter as eggs in leaves. Lacebugs that attack other deciduous plants like oaks with obvious leaf discoloration will winter as adults in bark crevices or leaf litter. Lacebugs tend to thrive on plants in sunny areas or in simple landscapes that lack a diversity of plants that can shelter or feed natural enemies. These enemies include green lacewing adults, their larvae, spiders, as well as sucking predators like assassin bugs. Lacebugs rarely, if ever, threaten the health of host trees like sycamores, lindens, and oaks. Unsightly damage on shrubs like cotoneasters, azaleas, and rhododendrons can be avoided by planting them in shaded places that can be irrigated. Chemical control is best achieved by targeting the immature stages in the spring with either a foliar insecticide or an appropriate soil-applied systemic product. Acelaprin is a product that is available to professionals that kills lacebugs with minimal impacts on pollinators. You can confirm your diagnosis at PurduePlantDoctor.com. This webpage helps you diagnose thousands of problems on hundreds of different kinds of plants. Simply type lacebug, L-A-C-E-B-U-G, and select lacebug from the drop-down menu to get recommendations for managing them on trees, and lacebugs with flowers if you're plant happens to be a flowering plant. So by selecting lacebugs, you get an information sheet with key features, including photos of the stippling, as well as a close-up of the adults, which you can get by clicking on the picture to confirm your diagnosis. You can also review symptoms, as well as details about the biology and management recommendations. We include a number of different products here, including acelaprin, neem oil, soap, and oil that can kill lacebugs with minimal impacts on beneficials and pollinators. You should remember to take this list with you when you go to the store to look for a product to help you manage your lacebugs. But before you go to the store, it would be a good idea to compare some of the lookalikes, like spider mites. When you click on the link, you can see images of spider mite-infested plants that are covered in webs and generally lack the black fecal spots that's associated with lacebugs. So please be sure to visit our Plant Doctor webpage, and don't let your plant problems get you down.